Welcome to the pathology lecture series on breast. In this lecture series, I'll be talking about every diseases of breast. So before starting, let us build some proper base on the clinical anatomy of breast so that understanding each and every disease will be made more easy. If you're new to my channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it so that you'll not miss out any of my upcoming videos on various topics in med school. So let us classify the parts of the breast as under the following four headings, and the diseases associated with the breast will be discussed under the following headings. Okay, for example, let us see that in this picture I have classified the parts of the breast as four main parts. So starting from the lobules and terminal ducts, which are present in the top most part of this picture right here, is what you see in this picture right here. This one right here is called as terminal duct lobular unit. Okay, I'll tell you why it is called as terminal duct lobular unit. The main structures which are present right here, which are in the shape of grapes, are called as alveoli or acinus. Okay, so these are what are going to secrete milk in pregnant women. These acini or alveolus will have multiple which will have small duct which will open into the main large duct. Okay, these small ducts are called as terminal duct. Okay, so this is a acini and this is a terminal duct. This is a acini and this is a terminal duct. It's like that. Okay, so what is a lobule then? A lobule is nothing but collection of multiple acini along with their terminal duct. So this one right here is a single lobule, and this one right here is a lobule. So multiple lobules will open their ducts into the large duct, which is the second part which we are going to discuss now. So the large duct, as I've told you, is formed by the opening of multiple terminal ducts. So this one right here is a large duct. This large duct is also called as lactiferous duct. This lactiferous duct is lined by two layers of epithelial cells. So within the lumen, the lining layer of epithelium is called as luminal epithelium, and just next to it, just under the luminal epithelium is what is called as myoepithelial cells. These myoepithelial cells are very important in ejecting the milk out of the breast, because on contraction of the myoepithelial cells, what will happen is there will be facilitation of ejection of the milk out of the breast during feeding of the baby. So that's about the large duct. Now about intralobular stroma. This right here, this region marked in green color right here, is what is called as intralobular stroma. This is basically the stroma which is present within the lobule system. Okay, this stroma is a bit different from the stroma which is present out of it, as you can see here, which is marked in yellow color. This stroma which is present outside the lobule is called as interlobular stroma. So what does the word inter means? Inter means between, right? So this stroma is present between the lobules, so it is called as interlobular stroma. And there are specific diseases which arise from each and every individual parts which we have mentioned in this video, in this particular picture. Okay, so let's move on. In this picture, you can see a small dilatation which is present near the end of the large duct. This will be present in each and every duct, but in this picture I have drawn this dilatation only in one particular lobe. This dilatation is called as lactiferous sinus. So in lactating women, some amount of milk will be constantly stored in the lactiferous sinus. Okay, that is lactiferous sinus, and multiple large ducts will open on the external skin surface on the nipple, as you can see in this picture. This picture is to show the suspensory ligaments of Cooper mainly. Okay, so you can see the pectoralis major muscle right here. Just over the pectoralis major muscle is pectoral fascia. From the pectoral fascia, multiple suspensory ligaments arise which will anchor to the undersurface of the skin covering the breast. So these suspensory ligaments are called as suspensory ligaments of Cooper. So What is the importance of suspensory ligaments, ligament of Cooper? This on invasion of the suspensory ligament of Cooper, what will happen is that there'll be contraction of the suspensory ligament of Cooper, leading to a specific change on the skin of the breast. If any of you guys know what that particular change which occurs on the surface of the skin on invasion of the suspensory ligament of Cooper, make sure to leave it in the comment section of this video. And if you're the first person to do it, you'll get a shout out in my next video. So now let's move on. This is a oversimplified picture of a single lobe. Okay, so what is a single lobe now? We'll see it in detail, in a bit more detail. In this particular point, we're starting from the nipple and we're entering into a single lobe. Here we have the distal part of the lactiferous duct, and there is a small dilatation which is called as lactiferous sinus, and further moving on, it is the continuation of the lactiferous duct, which is the large duct right here, this thing, the whole thing. And in the large duct, there are multiple opening of various terminal ducts which are arising from acini, and this single thing right here comprising of various acini and terminal ducts is called a single lobule. As you can see here, there are multiple lobules opening into the large duct. Okay, so this is a picture to simplify a single lobe present in the breast. So if you guys like these pictures, please make sure to hit the like button. So let us see that this let us talk about the diseases of the breast as an overview. Okay, so what disease arises from what part of the breast discussed previously? From the lobules and terminal ducts, diseases like benign diseases like cyst, sclerosing adenosis, small duct papilloma, and hyperplasia can arise, and a disease called atypical hyperplasia, which is associated with very high risk of turning into malignancy, can also arise. And in addition to that, carcinoma, which is the malignancy of breast, can also arise from this particular place in the breast. Now, further moving on to the large ducts, diseases like duct ectasia, squamous metaplasia of lactiferous ducts, large duct papilloma, and Paget disease can arise. From the intralobular stroma, one of the most common disease in the breast called fibroadenoma, and another disease called Phyllod's tumor can arise. And from the interlobular stroma, diseases like fat necrosis, lipoma, fibromatosis, and a very rare malignant tumor called sarcoma can arise. So I'll be talking about each and every individual diseases in separate videos in detail. So this is the first video in the pathology lecture series on breast, and as I promised you, I'll be making videos on every diseases of the breast. For me to understand that you guys want more videos on pathology of the breast, I need a favor from you guys. So I'll release the next video on pathology of breast on reaching 30 likes in this video. Okay, so if I reach 30 likes in this video, I'll come to know that you guys really need more lecture videos on pathology of breast, and I'll be making more pathology videos on breast. So if you guys support, if you guys want to support my channel, you can visit this website, patreon.com/medvidsmadesimple, and you can support my channel by donating there. And you can check out my blog page at medvidsmadesimple.blogspot.com, where I'll be making some tips and tricks to survive in med school. So if you are interested, make sure to check it out. And you can follow me on Instagram at medvidsmadesimple1, and you can ask me your doubts and any other thing which you wanna ask me in my Instagram page. And you can follow my Facebook page at facebook.com/medvidsmadesimple, where I'll be posting the same video I post on my YouTube channel. And in addition to that, I'll be posting some interesting MCQs which I find in any interesting textbooks. So we came to the end of this video. If you like this video, please make sure to hit the like button right now, and remember that I'll be making the upcoming videos on pathology of breast only on reaching 30 likes in this video. So make sure to share this video to your friends and tell them to hit the like button too. And if I reach 30 likes on this video, I'll be releasing the next lecture video on pathology of breast as soon as I reach 30 likes in this video. So thank you guys for watching this video till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.